So right now I'm going to the reading. It's called Giraffes Can't Dance. So here we go. All right. Gerald was a tall giraffe whose neck was long and slim, but his knees were awfully crooked and his legs were rather thin. He was very good at standing still and munching shoots of trees, but when he tried to run around, he buckled at the knees. Seems like the brother giraffe was a little clumsy there. All right. Now every year in Africa, they hold the jungle dance where every single animal turns up to skip and prance. And this year when they had the day arrived, poor Gerald felt so sad because when it came to dancing, he was really very bad. So as you can see, they have the annual jungle dance with the animals in Africa, and Gerald sits on the sideline because of how he feels about his dancing abilities. So he doesn't dance while everybody else is dancing. The warthog started waltzing, and the rhinos rock and roll. The lions danced a tango that was elegant and bold. The chimps all did a cha-cha with a very Latin feel, and eight baboons then teamed up for a splendid Scottish reel. Doing all these dances from other places. As you can see, I guess these animals are very well cultured. I guess they got around a little bit. Gerald swallowed bravely as he walked toward the floor, but the lion saw him coming and they began to roar. "Hey, look at clumsy Gerald," the animals all sneered. "Giraffes can't dance. You silly fool. Oh, Gerald, you're so weird." So Gerald's dancing, or lack of dancing skills has caused for him to be object of scrutiny amongst his peers. But that seemed not to stop his confidence. He still comes around. Well, I guess he can't hide. He's the tallest thing out there. So it'd be kind of hard for him to try to hide anywhere. Gerald simply froze up. He was rooted to the spot. "They're right," he thought. "I'm useless. Oh, I feel like such a clot." So he crept off from the dance floor and he started walking home. He never felt so sad before, so sad and so alone. Boys and girls and ladies and gentlemen, we should never let anyone make us feel this way, so sad and so alone. Even with yourself, you shouldn't be alone. You know, you should be confident in being by yourself, even though no one else wants to fool with you or they want to ridicule you and talk about you. It doesn't matter. You should always be cool with who you are. Then he found a little clearing and he looked up at the sky. "The moon can be so beautiful," he whispered with a sigh. "Excuse me," coughed a cricket who seen Gerald earlier on. "But sometimes when you're different, you just need a different song." See, Gerald was too worried about dancing and impressing everybody else and not going to the own beat of his own drummer. And that's what all of us need to do. Instead of going with the crowd, find your own rhythm. And that's what the cricket was trying to tell him. "Listen to the swaying grass and listen to the trees. To me, the sweetest music is those branches in the breeze. So imagine that lovely moon is playing just for you. Everything's making music if you really want it to." So it looks like they're coming from another perspective of instead of the traditional music, he's listening to the leaves, the branches. What else? What does he say? breeze, the branches. Oh yeah, that was it. Listen to the trees as well. So he's trying to find his own groove, basically, through other means. With that, the cricket smiled and picked up his violin. Then Gerald felt his body do the most amazing thing. His hooves had started shuffling, making circles on the ground. His neck gently swaying, and his tail was swinging around. Now the cricket had found a violin for Gerald to get a little groove with it, and kind of feeling himself now. He started shaking his tail and shuffling on the ground with his hooves. So seems like he's getting into it, getting a little confidence about himself. He threw his legs out sideways and he swung them everywhere. Then he did a backward somersault and leapt up in the air. Now all this coming from a person that couldn't even walk straight, was very clumsy, wasn't sure of himself. And now he's up here turning backflips like it ain't nothing. Gerald felt so wonderful. His mouth was open wide. "I am dancing. Yes, I'm dancing. I am dancing," Gerald cried. Then one by one, each animal who'd been there at the dance arrived while Gerald boogied on and watched him quite entranced. They shouted, "It's a miracle. We must be in a dream. Gerald's the best dancer that we've ever seen." So all the time everybody was ridiculing Gerald, and he out here got more moves than anybody, but his confidence wouldn't let him make it. That's all you need sometimes in life, is a little bit of confidence in yourself, just a little bit of belief, because that'll go a long, long way. You can't worry about the affairs of others, especially if they do not concern you. "How did you learn to dance like that? Please, Gerald, tell us how." But Gerald simply twirled around and finished with a bow. So now Gerald's stunting on him. He already showed out. Now he's stunting. They asked him, "How did you learn?" He just took a bow. That's all he did. He said, "Thank you." And that's what you do to haters sometimes. You know, you can't really worry about them, can't carry them on. If they're going to see it, they're going to see it. If not, everybody's not going to recognize your greatness. And once they do, you just be gracious enough and you carry on and do about your business. You ain't got to rub it in nobody's face. You just go about your business and keep on working and doing what you're doing. Then he raised his head and looked up at the moon and the stars above. "We all can dance," he said, "when we find the music we love." That's it. So the moral of that story was basically Gerald couldn't dance. Well, he thought he couldn't dance because he was dancing to the beat and listening to what everybody else was saying. When he found his own beat, when he found his own rhythm, his own groove, he was able to thrive, right? Yeah. So like I said, people, this is what's just another example of what believing in yourself can do. Never doubt yourself. Always bet on you, no matter what nobody else says. So with that, man, like I said, continue to support us. Like I said, we got that multinational book drive coming up. $10,000 is for 20 cities. So like I said, it's $500 a city. Please go check our website. Also, www.blacktolife, that's black2life.org. Check out some of the things we've been doing, some of the things we're going to continue to do, things in the future. And man, just continue to support us, and we'll keep on getting as many books to these kids and keep on ingratiating ourselves in these communities. And we will continue to always empower Black men to strengthen our underserved communities through education and inspiration. Thank y'all for stopping in with us tonight, listening to this book, and I'm out. Peace.